I always say to the people of America, I will go back again. America has brought a lot of people from, especially from Ghana, women from Ghana, America has brought them.
They want to spoil it.
Huh?
They want to spoil it.
They want to spoil it. America. Especially women from Africa, they come to the United States and they change. They begin to wear the pants.
They sit in place and they change.
They think that the men think that they are wearing, that makes them men. Are you hearing me? My wife wears pants to work.
Mm-hmm.
But she can never be the man of the house. I'm too big for that.
Hallelujah!
Amen. Never booby. If you beat them, I'll beat you back. That's his biggest gallon. Now, over here in America, the law has separated the men. But don't beat your wife. No, it's not good. It's not good.
But you can beat your wife.
The women are beating the men because they know the law has separated the men. Pastor Michael, I'm telling you, many homes and many families are breaking apart because the women are taking over.
Are you? The woman is too big and you are too skinny.
is what I love. I said, God bless you. And the other way, let's love them. As a husband, our number one priority is to love our wives. But only if the wives know their duties in the house. They don't quarrel with you. We are flesh and blood. Argument may break, but find a way to break it down. Because where there is no head, there is chaos. Where there is no head, there will be confusion.
Yes.
Remember, a man is the head of the house, as Christ is the head of the church. Before I bring my message to an end, give me the Colossians chapter 3, the verse number 18.
Colossians chapter 3, verse 18. Wives, submit to your husbands. It says, wives, submit to your husbands as is fitting in the Lord.
Continue.
Verse 19. Husbands, love your wives and do not be harsh with them.
Do what?
Husbands, love your wives
and do not
do
what?
Not be harsh with them.
And do not
be harsh.
Harsh.
I got it.
Listen, I do it sometimes. You know, women love to talk. So when they begin to talk, sometimes I watch TV. My man, I'm listening, but I'm watching TV. And the talking is too much. Do you understand? Man, let's be realistic. It happened to us. Sometimes you can go home when you come back from work, you are so tired. And the woman wants to talk, and the time they want to talk. I pay attention, but my mind is somewhere else. And they don't like it when you don't say anything. Let go to a place where we can respect our husband. Husband, respect your wives. They carry babies for 9 months. You cannot do so. So your job is to do what? Love them and to bring them to a place where they will feel the embracement of God.
Amen.
Women, you are so special to men. We love you. But make sure they give us that benefit of doubt. As men, we are the head. No matter what you do, I'm the head of the house. No matter what, you cannot tell me to be a woman. And that will turn up again.
Amen. For David.
But if one girl become one of you, then you know me because I'm a man. And that's the point. If you dare not. But listen, what is good? These two hands work together. All these hands work together. Love your wife and love your husband. Husbands, love your wife. Women, love your husband. And these two work together. If this love takes place in the family, you can't see anything like Ayefinochi.
Wow.
And the man, I'll end it right here. The man, the number one thing that breaks relationship, you know it. When the daughter comes for you to do your duty, handle your duties well. A woman makes sure that you handle your duties well, rather than the worst of do what you don't do, and I have the certificate. Say, my wife, you did a good job today. My husband did a good job today. Do it well.
Never.
And God will bless you.
Amen.
I said, do handle your business.
Never.
You see, your mess are quiet.
Never.
You see, your women are so quiet.
Never.
May God bless you.
Amen.